Hey everyone, so in this video I want to give you a little bit of a preview of what things are going to work like once you finish this particular part of the MP. So if you finish the first checkpoint, when you load up your app, you're going to see the summary view. That's what we're going to call it, start calling this. This is the view that allows us to scroll and to list all the courses and to filter and things like that. But what do we do when we want more information about a specific class? So, you know, typically, you know, just the title and the course number may not be enough information for us to make a decision about the class. There may be more things that we may want to know. And so here's what we're going to do for this checkpoint. And this is going to turn out to require more work than maybe you might think. But we're going to set this up so that when I click on a class, like I click on freshman orientation, I'm taken to a new activity that displays information about that class. Now, the back button here is actually optional. You don't have to implement that if you don't want to. But what you do, it's kind of nice, right? Because you do want to be able to get back to the previous place. But you know, I should be able to click on any one of these courses and find out more information about it. And what we're showing here in this view, and you can decide to put more in here if you would like, or you might want to extend this as the as part of your final project when you get a chance to do something on your own. So for right now, if you look at what's being shown, I'm showing the course title pretty much exactly the same way that we showed it on the summary view, formatted the same way. But then I'm also showing this other new piece of information. This is the description of the course. And that's information that you're going to have to fetch separately from your backend. And so so what's actually happening here, let's look at this one more time. So when I click on one of these courses, like let's click on CS125, what's happening is there's a new activity that's being launched. And this is sort of backwards from the way that you actually want to work on it. So please don't try to approach the MP in this direction. You actually want to work the other direction. When I click, this new activity gets started. That activity then goes to the server, remember the server that provided us with that list of courses, and asks for information about a specific course using a protocol or an agreement about what that route looks like that we'll talk about in the MP write-up. The server sends back a piece of JSON that contains not just the information that you had available in the summary view, where it was like the semester and the year and the department and the title, but also a bunch of other information. So the course catalog has all sorts of really rich information about every course, including the description, which is what we're showing here, but also stuff like information about credit hours and prerequisites and all sorts of stuff. Some of that stuff you might decide to use later on. So when the activity gets started, it asks the server for that information. When the server responds, the activity updates the display that you see to show that information to the user. So that's our goal for MP1. That's all we have to do. Now, accomplishing this is going to require a bunch of changes throughout the MP that we'll go into. But this is what things should look like when you're finished. As a little bit of sort of a bonus, or if you want to, just for your own enjoyment, you can get this back button to work. That's actually not tested by our test suites, which is fine, but it's something that you'll probably want to add just so that you don't drive yourself nuts trying to experiment with the MP. Okay, so that's all I have to do. Seems easy, right? Turns out to be a little more complicated, but we'll walk you through every step of the way.